Okay, so now we're going to touch base on snapping the football. So your center snaps the ball. Once the center snaps the ball, he is free and eligible to go out and into a route. Okay. So now a couple things to remember when you're snapping the football. All right. Most people are going to tell you to grab the football just like you would if you were to throw it. Okay. Please don't look at my hands. I've never snapped the ball that way. I've always snapped it this way. It's also the way I throw it without the laces. So that's why my hands are like that. Now, number two, you want to get your pointer finger as close to the top of the ball as possible, within 1 inch of the intersection, okay? Number two there with your grip, you want the middle of your thumb and forefinger down that lace, okay? So as you see right there. What this does is this allows people of all hand sizes to grip the football appropriately and have control over the ball, okay? Now, couple quick tips for when you're snapping. Number one, when you snap the ball, it needs to be one singular motion. Okay, one singular motion. There needs to be no break in that motion. All right, number two, the wrist should never break. All right, so as you snap the ball, you don't want your wrist to break up or break down. Excuse me, down or up. Okay, you want the wrist to stay locked. All right, number three, the forearm needs to hit the same place in the inner thigh always, regardless of the direction that the center is going once he snaps the football. Okay, so you have your grip, all right, 1 inch from the intersection, middle of the thumb and the forefinger right there in the web. Keep the wrist locked. Forearm always hits the same spot in the inner thigh, regardless of which way you're going. So once that happens, it should just be right here. Boom. When you get done, that pointer finger should point right to the quarterback.